In this video, you will learn how to use some of CODAP's features. CODAP stands for Common Online Data Analysis Platform and can be used for data visualization and exploratory data analysis. This video was made on November 21st, 2017, and reflects CODAP's current capabilities, which are continuously being updated. We're starting with some data on 300 different types of vehicles. As you can see in the top row of the table, each vehicle has several attributes, some numerical and some categorical. Data in the table can be sorted by clicking on an attribute and choosing one of the sort options. In addition, the table can be reorganized into categories by creating hierarchies. For example, if we drag the division attribute to the leftmost column, past the leftmost column of the table, the vehicles will be split up by vehicle manufacturer division. If you want to remove the hierarchy, drag the attribute back into the table. To view data in a graph, click on the top menu button labeled Graph. A blank graph will appear. To view the data for any attribute graphically, click on the attribute in the table and drag it to an axis. Here we have graphed city miles per gallon onto the x-axis. The default graph that has appeared is a dot plot. Click on any corner of the graph to resize. Notice that when you select a point on the graph or a group of points on the graph, they are also selected in the table. To display measures on the graph, make sure the graph is selected. A toolbar on the right-hand side of the graph will appear. Click on the ruler icon. You can select mean, median, and standard deviation to display those directly on the graph. To display the numerical values, hover over each line. Uncheck these in the toolbar to remove them from the graph. You also have the option of overlaying another attribute onto the dot plot by dragging it into the middle of the graph window. Notice a legend appears that describes the different colors on the graph. To create a text box, click on the top menu button labeled Text and type in the box that appears. To overlay a box plot on top of a dot plot, again, make sure the graph is selected. In the toolbar on the right-hand side again, click on the ruler icon. Choose the box plot option. Hover over each section of the box plot to display the numerical values that are used to construct the box plot. Notice that an outlier appears as an asterisk. If I wonder about how city miles per gallon is similar or different if the vehicle is a hybrid, I can add that attribute to the y-axis. I can also rearrange the table back into a hierarchy according to whether the cars are hybrid or not. In the table, I can add new attributes if I wanted to enter additional data, or create an attribute based on a formula by clicking on this plus sign or on this plus sign. When a table is arranged hierarchically, it can be useful to compute measures for a category. For example, I can compute the mean of the city MPG and the standard deviation of the city MPG here so that I can easily compare these measures for each of these groups of vehicles. To compare bivariate data, drag another numerical attribute to the y-axis. A scatter plot appears. If the data look linear, I could use a moveable line and show the squared residuals to help me estimate a model. I could also choose to display a computed least squares line and the R-squared value. To remove an attribute, click on the axis and choose the Remove option. To display categorical data, drag an attribute to an axis. You can also drag another categorical attribute to the other axis. Use the ruler icon to display the count and percent of each category. On the toolbar here, you will notice a map, which is useful if your data set includes geographical information such as latitude and longitude or map boundaries. A slider can be used to define a parameter that can be used in computing formulas for new attributes in the table or for graphing functions in the graph window. For example, you could create a slider called A and then graph a function which is under the ruler in the graph window, such as y equals a over x. Notice there's also a plugin icon. This includes access to a set of tools that can be added, such as a sampler, that can be used to design probability models and run experiments, or sample from a collection of data. Have fun exploring all that CODAP can do.